Greetings. I am continuing to review verses and reasonings which appear to refute the rapture. Remember, verses may refute, may confirm, or may do neither. This video discusses the Day of the Lord, Matthew 24:30. In Matthew 24:30, Christ said the sign of the Son of Man would be after the tribulation of those days when the sun is darkened and the moon turns blood red. He didn't say the sign of the Son of Man would be before the tribulation of those days. I really think these are great questions to ask and consider, brother. And as a lesson for myself, I should slow down and read more carefully. The first three times I read your question, I thought about the Day of the Lord. But now, beginning video preparation, I finally see Sign of the Lord. Don't! That makes a difference, doesn't it? Let's read Matthew 24:30 in some context, but not all of Matthew 24 per se. But that's going to be really, really hard to do. Context, context, context. Nearly all of Matthew 24 supplies the context. Okay, I've got to take a deep breath. Matthew 24:30. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. First, this is a sign. A sign is to communicate some message. Evidently, this sign brings bad news, great sadness. And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. Matthew 24:29. Immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken. Slam dunk! This is after the tribulation of those days, as Matthew 24 describes. And other verses confirm this is the end. Matthew 24:14, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. Matthew 24:21, for then shall be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time, no, nor ever shall be. For as the lightning comes out of the east and shines even to the west, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. I think this pretty clearly speaks of the second coming of Christ. And this will happen after the great tribulation. Now, what exactly is the sign of the Son of Man in heaven? Is it his appearance on the horse of Revelation 19:11? Revelation 19:11. Then I saw heaven opened, and there was a white horse. Its rider is called Faithful and True, and he judges and makes war in righteousness. His eyes were like a fiery flame, and many crowns were on his head. He had a name written that no one knows except himself. He wore a robe stained with blood, and his name is the Word of God. The armies that were in heaven followed him on white horses, wearing pure white linen. Now, if I saw that in the clouds, and I did not know who this was, you bet your life that would be a sign. A sign I needed to change my underpants. And I looked and searched for another usage of sign and sun, to see if there are any other details of the sign of the Son of Man. And Bible Hub search returned no New Testament or end time results. Whenever I find a topic mentioned in only one verse, I really slow down my rush to judgment. And I think while certain phrases are clearly related to end time events, their relationships are not always absolutely establishable. The identification and gathering his bride, the marriage supper of the Lamb, the Day of the Lord, the sign of the Son of Man, the destruction of Damascus, the Gog and Magog War, the second coming of Christ, the rapture. Just to be clear, the relationships of these events are not always absolutely clear. But there is one more verse I would like to consider in this video. Revelation 19:31. And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they shall gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. This verse really looks like Matthew 24:31. He will send out his angels with a loud trumpet, and they will gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of the sky to the other. He will send out his angels, and he shall send his angels, with a loud trumpet, with a great sound of a trumpet, and they will gather his elect, and they shall gather together his elect, from the four winds, from one end of the sky to the other, from the four winds, from one end of the heaven to the other. Repeating this verse amplifies the certainty. To me, this means there will be a gathering after the tribulation signaled by a trumpet. And this verse really could cast some doubt on the rapture. If there is only one gathering of Christians, it also presents another or third alternative to part 4, the two trumps. Here we see the gathering is signaled by a trumpet sound. But maybe, just maybe, this is only to gather the Calvinists, his elect. Sorry, I couldn't resist. Allah made me this way. I am just so stinking serious all of the time. Anyway, I agree that verse 19:31 actually presents a gathering that happens at a trumpet after the tribulation. As such, it is probably the strongest verse I've seen to challenge a pre-trib rapture directly. But we have to ask, does this final gathering preclude an earlier gathering? I do not think we can say for sure, so we should keep an open mind and keep looking. I think the rapture, like several debated and disputed Bible doctrines, have verses pro and con. Even when one verse appears to be absolute for one position or the other, it may be counterbalanced by another pointing the exact opposite way. Which is why I have grown less dogmatic the more I have learned. Some topics are more certain, and they are often also more critical. I am comfortable keeping Revelation 19:31 on the table in a list of scriptures to meditate on. I think it is also critical to keep Matthew 24:30 within the discussion. My faith and your faith should rest on the whole Word of God. God's revelation to us is called a mystery for a reason. Revelation 1:7 says, "Behold, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him, and all the tribes of the earth will mourn over him. So it is to be. Amen." Acts 1:11, "They also said, 'Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking into the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will come in just the same way as you have watched him go into heaven.'" Memorize this. This same Jesus will come in just the same way. When someone claims to be Jesus, but comes a different way, they will be a liar, a false Christ, a false prophet. Believe him not. Matthew 24:26. "So if someone tells you, 'Look, the Messiah is out in the desert,' don't bother to go and look. Or, 'Look, he is hiding here,' don't believe it." The false prophet is coming in Islam's name. Do not believe him. He is not Jesus of Nazareth. He is not Jesus Christ, the Son of Man. He is not Jesus Christ, the Son of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.